r/neckbeardstories by Redmond Dietus. Old alcoholic nice guy got too friendly to me for a year and a half. Writing this on Reddit app, so sorry for the weird format. Bit about myself, I'm a 5'3" girl from the UK and at the time of this story I had dyed my hair a lot. Important later on in the story. So I'm just going to jump right into this story cuz I'm not really that good starting a stories. I was working in a off-license liquor store around 2015 or 2016. I was about 20 to 23 and usually had regulars come in and it was normal for them to talk to me for a few minutes then leave and I didn't mind this. I liked talk to people. So one day of me working this man comes in that I've never met before. He was about in his late 50s. Dirty hair, had the most annoying laugh. Imagine Mutterly's laugh if he smoked 100 cigarettes a day for 10 years straight. I'm just going to call him from now on for this story Ben. So Ben comes in and he gets a case of Guinness and I ring it up for him. Then he stood there and spoke to me saying, "Oh, I never met you before here, blah blah blah." I can't remember the whole convocation but I remember him talking to me for 40 minutes to an hour. Mind. Normally people got the stuff and left. Only reason I didn't ask him to leave is because I thought he must not have no one to talk to and he's just lonely so I just talked to him. He left and I asked my sister who was in the back to see normally do that and she last time he stayed for 30 minutes or so talking to her so he does normally do this so I thought nothing of this and I did the rest of my job and went home for the night. A few days later, maybe a week, I was heading up to get coffee and pananas for me and my sister and I see Ben standing outside the pub and he stopped me to talk to me. He was telling me about his daughter being bullied and me knowing how it feels to get bullied. I just said bullies can just go F themselves and not get any attention. Then he goes yeah. And out of nowhere he grabs my face and goes to kiss me. I managed to move my face and he got my cheek. I was stunned by this. All that went through my head was how the F do you get out of the situation. So I just stutter and say I've to go get coffee for me and my sister, and quickly got out of there and luckily when I was went the same direction, on the other side of the street, he was back inside. I told my sister and she was like what the F? And kinda make fun of me for it. I hadn't seen him for a while after this incident happened so I kinda forgot about it, until he came back in with his friend. I'll call her Jane. So I've met Jane a few times and quite liked her. She wasn't creepy, she was nice and had a dog that was so cute. So Jean and Ben came in and he got his usual and I can't remember what she got, and Jane paid after Ben and she talked to me for a few minutes so I asked could she have a hug. I don't mind hugging people as long as they ask. So I said sure and I hugged her and Ben was to the right of when we did and as soon as she let go of hugging me, he decides I want a hug so just grabs me and hugs me and I was like the F is he doing? And I didn't put my arms around him or anything and Jane said will you get off her Ben Jesus Christ. So he didn't without saying anything left, and my sister looked and are you okay cuz she knows I'm not the biggest fan of being touched but as I said I don't mind if someone asks for a hug and I was like yeah I'm fine. I wasn't but I wanted to forget about it. I used to dye my hair about back in 2015-2016 and my next dye job was pink which I loved. And I had just got my hair done this day and Ben and Jane sees me and this mother sucker decides to grab my hair and say I really love your hair. He didn't pull it or anything just had it in his hand. I was like oh thanks I wanted to hit his hand away but I didn't know his grip on it and I'm not going to hurt my head over this creep. I think Jane seen the look of my face and said something to him when I was away from them cuz he barely spoke to me for a while after that. So a few weeks goes by and I don't see him thankfully, until he came to the off-license for the last time. An incident happened after I was working, it has nothing to do with the story but that made him not come back into the off-license. And I was getting off work soon, about 20 minutes and he asked was I on for the night and I said no I'm going home soon. This creepy sucker asked me where I lived. As soon as I say that he said and where is home? And I said my house. My pregnant sister want to come out and I seen and I didn't want her to get stressed so that's why I responded so quickly. This lying bastard, bad liar may I say, said oh I thought you meant you were going to work somewhere else. How? How did this idiot think I was going to believe that? He leaves and my sister says to me what's that about? I've three sisters. My sister at the start was my older sister. This is my younger sister, and my other sister wasn't in this story. So I told her the situation and she told me just to be careful of him, which I was already doing, but I just agreed. A few months go by and I don't see him, and it was great. I wasn't scared of walking up the street and bumping into him or seeing him in the shop, but that unfortunately stops until I see him in the pub, and I was trying to ignore, but he wasn't making it easy. But he left thankfully and told the guy behind the bar with I knew. We'll call him Ryan. Cuss, Ben always came into this pub and asked him to tell Ben to leave me alone. Cuss, I was getting scared at this point, thinking is he going to follow me home or something. I told Ryan the whole situation and everything he did, and he said leave it to me, I'll tell him to leave you alone. So I thought great, I don't have to worry about him anymore, I don't have to be scared anymore. Until I went back into the pub and he was there. At first he didn't speak to me, didn't look at me. Nothing. Until the bartender left. It wasn't Ryan, it was a different bartender that didn't know the situation. This was probably about 1 in the afternoon, and I don't drink but like be social, so I normally drink Coke in the pub, so the bartender was busy sorting out the drinks and stuff for the night time, so she didn't have to when it was too busy. The bartender went to the back and she left me and Ben alone. Then he starts to talk to me. And he says, Ryan says I was being inappropriate with you and you were uncomfortable with me, and I kinda got the confidence to say yeah you were being inappropriate, and start listing the things he has done. And while I was saying this, the bartender comes back and she gives me look as in what's going on, are you okay? So I said I need to go to the bathroom and gesture to her to go there, and I told her what was happening and that I've already told Ryan to tell him to leave me alone, and obviously he didn't. So she told me to go sit somewhere else and not near him so he doesn't bother me. So I did. That didn't work, cuz when he went to the bathroom and came back, he came over and started talking to me, and I was just acting rude, not looking up from my phone, say yup and hum when he said anything to me. Until the bartender sees and said I think she wants left alone Ben, and then he left me alone for a bit, and then Ryan came in for his shift and me and the bartender told him what happened. This pissed Ryan off, cuz Ben was told not even to look at me, let alone talk to me. So the bartender had to go to an appointment, so it was just me, Ryan and Ben in the pub, and I was away from the bar, I think that's what it's called, the place where you order the drinks from. And Ryan and him were sitting there at the bar, and Ryan started to talk to Ben, and the conversation went like this. Ryan, what did I say about leaving her alone? Ben, I did nothing wrong. I wouldn't do anything to her, I've daughters myself. You were making her feel uncomfortable and you were made aware of that, so why continue to speak to her when you know she's uncomfortable? Ben says nothing and looks down. Look at me and tell me you're not going to go near her again. Ben same. Not talking and not looking at him. Right, just listen then. If you go back near her again, I will make sure you're done for harassment. Ryan starts doing something I'm not what, but stops talking to Ben and takes no notice of them. Ben starts staring at him. Ryan. What are you looking at? Ben says nothing and just stares at him. Ryan goes from behind the bar and says, what are you looking at? And Ben still says nothing and stares at him. Ryan got pissed, and I swear if there wasn't cameras he would have beat him. Ryan took his glass of Guinness and he told him to get out, and he got up and he says as he's leaving, I'm going to pray for you, and Ryan replied, do what you want, but as long as you don't go near her and get out I really don't care, and then Ben left. I have no idea why, but I cried my eyes out. I'm not sure if it was the fear of Ryan getting hurt or the relief that Ben won't talk to me anymore, maybe a mixture of both. Thankfully after that day I haven't seen him. Last I heard he moved to a different city and far away from me. TLDR, old alcoholic harasses me and gets told to leave me alone, 9 still doesn't until he got threatened to do so. Being a woman sucks sometimes. Every effing interaction with a dude seems to have about a 7% chance of going wrong. My wife was walking to work today in a pirate costume. Not a slutty one. Like really close to Depp in Pirates of the Caribbean in fact, and some douche in a lifted truck pulls over to ask for directions. She just keeps walking. Homeboy starts to then ask if she's single, tell her she's beautiful and such. Keeps walking. He calls her a bitch and then drives off hard. That's all folks. Thank you for watching. Have a nice evening.